Hello, fellow witches and wizards. My name is Phoenix Jenny, and welcome back to Let's Play Sherlock Holmes Nemesis, Sherlock Holmes versus Arsène Lupin. Hello, hello, hello. Make sure you can hear me okay. Stream is going. I hope. Okay. Was okay. So perfect. Great. Awesome. Okay, so I will remind you that I am currently looking for jobs right now, so there is a chance that the stream will get interrupted with a call. If that happens, I will interrupt the stream. I'll put up my intermission screen if that happens. And but I will come right back to the stream as soon as the call is done. That has not happened yet. However, I did receive a call this morning, and I do have a job interview tomorrow morning. So pray that that goes well. Or doesn't, if I don't want the job, if the job's not good. That's kind of where I'm at in my headspace right now. There's a part of me that's like, yes, I want a job. I want money and stability and all those things. But then there's a part of me that doesn't want a job because I don't want to be unhappy. I don't want to have to, I'd have to change my stream schedule entirely. Like, I'd have to drop, I wouldn't be able to dedicate as much time to my YouTube channel or writing or anything like that. So, just pray that it goes well. Yeah, so there's that. Hello, hello, welcome to the stream. You can speak to me live in the comment section right over there. And unless you're watching this video after the fact, which you can comment down below. Please leave a like on the stream. It helps out, tells YouTube that you like it, and it'll share it so that other people will watch. If you haven't already, click the subscribe button so you can be notified the next time I go live and the next time I upload a video. My uploads are a little strange right now because I'm having fun doing other things. I've decided, when I first started doing YouTube, I decided I didn't want to be bound by it. I didn't want to have to upload every single day and like be like, oh, I don't have a video for today. What am I gonna do? I upload when I upload, like YouTube isn't a career for me. It's a hobby. It's something I do in my free time. So, it's like I feel like playing Nancy Drew. I already streamed something else, so let's record it. Like, oh, I feel like playing Nancy Drew, so I'm gonna record myself playing Nancy Drew. I'm recording myself or streaming myself doing what I would already be doing. Right now, I'm kind of reading in my free time or playing Fuser, the game Fuser. It's an awesome game, but there's no way I can stream it or record it because YouTube would hate me because it's riddled with copywritten music, and I wouldn't have it any other way. Plus, it's fun to just play something that's not that I don't have to post. It's just something that I just do for fun. So I've been doing that instead. I worked on a speed build. I finished my video, my Sims video for part three for my Snowy Escape Let's Play. That's all done. It'll be released on Thursday. and I worked on a speed build. That's all done. I just have to edit the footage and do my voiceover for it. But the speed build for my Ryokan Komorebi, which is on the gallery right now if you want it. My gallery ID for The Sims 4 is Phoenix Jenny, but it's Eonix instead of OE. It's spelled incorrectly. It's there if you want to see it, but the speed build will be up on the channel soon-ish. I finished Nancy Drew. I'm going to start playing The Deadly Device. I'm planning on recording it. If I don't get to it, I might stream it. But I plan on recording The Deadly Device. That'll be the next game in our Wintery series. And then I'm working on True Fear as well. Now, there's a whole story about that, okay? I've recorded part 20, and I had a lovely viewer suggest to me that I record my commentary by way of Audacity, which is a free downloadable software that you can use to edit the background noise out, because as you can tell, my audio quality is not great. You can hear my fan. You can hear it right now. My computer fan. When I built my computer, I wasn't thinking about YouTube and like quiet fans is like It's much better. Like, I only had a set amount of money, and I'd rather dedicate that money to an awesome graphics card as opposed to quiet fans. So I was like, give me the cheapest fan you got. I don't care. So therefore, they're super, super loud and annoying. And so Audacity is really great with editing out audio, except for whatever reason, I can't get the audio to match the visual. Like, I do have to cut out a bit because I press record on my Audacity, and then I have to get into the game because I can't click out of the game. So I'm playing in the game and stuff while Audacity is running. But I edit out the quiet part right up to when I press the record button to record the visual. You'd think that the commentary would just go seamlessly along with it. It's both recording at the same time, but for whatever reason, I can't make it line up. I would have the audio over top of the video, and it would be like 8 seconds behind. And so then I'd fix it. Okay, well, I'll just like delay the video at the beginning with some sort of intro screen or whatever as the audio's going, and it'll catch up. It does, but then it gets exponentially slower, and I don't know how that happens. Like, my voice hasn't changed or anything. The thing about that particular video, about part 20, and I'll release a whole video about this if you miss this, but I mean, like, because I'm gonna have to. Okay, it's a long story. I'm gonna have to re-record. I'm gonna have to record commentary on top of the video because I can't use the audio clip that I can't use the commentary that I recorded while I was playing because it's too slow. Like, first of all, when it first recorded, my voice, the pitch of my voice was super low because I knocked over my microphone and I didn't know that it was broken, essentially, when I recorded. It's fixed now. I just unplugged it, replugged it in. It's fine now. But the audio clip was corrupt. I changed the pitch. I was able to speed up. I was able to put up the pitch just fine, and it works great. But for whatever the video is too slow now, or it doesn't match what's going on in the video. So I tried to go back to the original voice clip, and I couldn't fix the pitch again. So I'm like, okay, fine. My voice is going to be super low. It's going to be super weird sounding, but at least it'll match. It still doesn't match. I still wasn't able to edit it appropriately. I'm thinking the bit rate isn't right or something, but I don't know what bit rates are. I don't understand how it works. So, long story short, I'm gonna have to scrap the audio. I'm gonna have to do commentary over it, explaining this whole situation, and I'm probably not gonna use Audacity anymore. So my audio quality is gonna be garbage. Sorry, I just can't. Unless you guys know how that works and what's going on, I can't make the audio match the video, and that's not the only video where that's happened. So you'll see in my notes and other videos, like, yeah, my audio is slightly off. It corrects itself. I fix it, you know. But this one I could not fix. It took me hours, all the way into the middle of the night last night. And when I was recording that particular video, like, okay, so I was so angry. I just said, scrap it. I'm just going to record audio, a commentary on top of the video that I already made. Okay. So I did that. I got into the middle of the video when I looked at my recording and I realized I wasn't recording the desktop audio. And I'm like, that's it. I quit. I just shut down my computer, went to bed. Just too many things going wrong in one sitting. Just no. Just fed up with it. So so you're not going to be seeing part 20 for quite a while. So I'm just annoyed with it. But it's still, I'm still working on it is the point. So job interview tomorrow. If I do get the job, that does mean that my streaming schedule is going to be way different, and I don't exactly know what it's going to look like. But I'll let you know. And I don't know. Hopefully I won't get the job. Like I said, that's where I'm at. Like, I'm between a rock and a hard place. I want the job, and I don't want the job at the same time. But anyway, yeah, that's my life right now. Click subscribe. Click the bell icon. Streaming tomorrow. We'll be doing. I hope we won't be doing more of this game. Actually, why don't I go ahead and bring it up? We will be playing the game soon. Erica, shut up. We don't care. Just play the game. I'm super over this game. It's too hard, okay? It's too hard for me. I don't remember it being this hard. It's really hard to do puzzles and be entertaining at the same time. It's really hard. I just hope that you guys don't mind that it's difficult because it really is. I did move the screen over a little bit so you can see more of the gameplay, but it's not centered, so that might also be annoying. It's almost done. This game is almost done. We're in the last leg of it, or at least the second to last leg of it, from what I remember. I do have the silver earring. The silver earring is what we'd be playing next. It is already installed on my computer. I'll have to finagle it a little bit, but I did most of the finagling this morning, or earlier. It wasn't this morning, it was 1 o'clock. Let me know if the audio quality is good or not. Well, it's not gonna be good if you can hear it, is what I mean. Almost done with this, and then the silver earring will be even harder because I played that game once and it was years ago. I remember nothing about it. So the puzzles will probably be even more impossible because I won't remember them. So bear with me. Maybe that's fun for you to watch me struggle. I know it is for me when I watch other YouTubers play games and they suck at it. It's more fun for me. I don't know why. It makes me feel better about myself, I guess. Almost done with this. Then we're gonna play the silver earring. We might play it today. If we do, I'm gonna have to change the title of this video, but yeah. And if I do have to stop streaming, I will continue my YouTube channel. I just won't be able to keep up with it as often, but I will still finish the video. Like, I won't just stop a game and then never return to it. I do want to finish everything I start to the best of my ability, okay? Okay. And if you'd like to support what I do, please check out my Patreon, link in the description. If enough of you support me, I won't need a job and I could just do this forever. That'd be great. Not forever. This is actually to support my writing. That's initially what I wanted to do. But what's on the floor there? Nothing. Okay. Oh, they're making Rubens for the dog bones. Okay. I have no idea what we were doing. I don't even have the walkthrough up. I'm gonna try and not use a walkthrough, but I say that every time. Because this game sucks. It's so hard. Okay. Did I do it? I did something. Is it in my inventory? It is. Bowl of sauce. Captain sauce? I watched some Captain Sauce yesterday. He's a great YouTuber. If you don't know, he's very funny. Very funny.
It would be considered an act of
Oh,
treason to.
yeah, that's where the queen is. Sorry. Queen Victoria.
Calm down, my lord, calm down. Your breakfast is on its way.
The damsel wouldn't open her door for anything but her dog's breakfast. Dog's sense of smell is very keen. If this had been the correct recipe, he would have recognized it. Something must be missing.
No. I'm over it. Oh, am I supposed to combine it? Oh, chocolate. Yeah. It's disgusting. Okay. Oh, hello. I like your dress. I like your room. Very good look. It's a little pug.
But you aren't Deirdre.
Your powers of observation are stunning, my lady. Indeed, I am not Deirdre. My name is Sherlock Holmes, and I am
the new cook.
Not
Do
quite.
I look like a
Firstly,
cook to
where
you?
Can I place this meal?
Put my lord's breakfast at the foot of his bed. But, oh, I can't let an unknown person into my chamber. Good God, what will happen to me?
Nothing serious, my lady. In fact, I'm here to help you.
How do you know that I am in need of help? Help from a tall, distinguished man with a long, a very long nose.
My lady, my flair for detection has nothing to do with the size of my nose. For the help that I intend to provide, it solely concerns the dispute between yourself and Her Majesty.
Oh, don't talk of that. She will no longer speak to me. It's not even my fault. Oh, no.
Okay.
Why does Her Majesty reproach you?
3 days ago, she gave me the lovely dollhouse that you see there.
It's beautiful.
It was made specifically for me by the royal cabinet maker. It's magnificent, isn't it?
Indeed, the little candles in the chandeliers emphasize the lovely coloring of the dolls.
Yesterday, she came to see me in my chamber and noticed that 4 of the dolls were missing from the house. I wasn't even aware, but Deirdre, who had wrapped it, confirmed the fact. These dolls are precious, and Drina, I mean Her Majesty, was angry and told me that I didn't take care of the gifts that she gave me. I questioned my staff, my maid and my cook to no avail. I had them fired and thought that would suffice for Her Majesty, but no.
Hmm? Why did she call her Drina? I wonder what her actual name is. What often happens with English queens, or maybe any queen, is that they often change their name. And it's not just queens, too. Royalty, their names often get changed when they become a sovereign. So they might be born one name, and then when they become a sovereign, they take on a different name. Like Elizabeth II. If you've ever seen The Crown on Netflix, I highly recommend it. I haven't seen the second season because I'm kind of about them choosing a new actress. Because Claire Foy is Elizabeth II. But anyway, they say when she first becomes a sovereign, they say, "What do you want your name to be?" And she's like, "What? What are you talking about?" They're like, "Your father chose..." I forget what he chose. George, I think. Your father chose this to be his name as king. What would you like your name to be as queen? And she's like, Elizabeth. Well, that's not, I don't care about that. Just use my real name. So her name actually is Elizabeth. But I wonder if Victoria had an original name, had a name that wasn't Victoria at first. I don't know. I feel like I should know that kind of thing. She might have been born Victoria. I wonder if her name was something in the semblance of Drina. I don't know why she called her Drina. Also, I was going to say something else until I figured out what it was. So there's that. Why would she care about her dollhouse? That's another thing that I'm just like, what?
What the dolls look like?
I don't even know. All I know is that there are four less boys than girls in the dollhouse.
Okay. So we're
Please
looking
calm
for
yourself,
dolls.
My lady. I will see what I can do.
Oh, many thanks, sir. Thank you. If you find them, you will be handsomely rewarded. I will prove my gratitude, even if it means...
Thanks.
Save your gratitude for when I have solved the case.
What does that mean? I don't know. They make it sound super shady. Okay. Thanks, Victorian Barbie. I love her room. I love the pinkness of it. Oh, look at that. Oh, this is the dream. She's living the dream right now. Oh.
Water.
She has her bathtub over here. Isn't that normal to have your bathtub in your room? I mean, I'm not opposed to it. Mm-hmm. Look at this. It's beautiful. Okay, so... 4, 5, 6. There's 4 less boys than girls. Does that mean there's 8 girls and 4 boys? I don't know. It says a lot of pictures of her puppy. She kind of looks like Maya, PewDiePie's dog. Oh, so cute. Great. What am I supposed to do with that? I'm kind of cold. Oh, that's King George III, right? Looks like King George III. I'm fascinated with British history. I took modern British. Oh, look. Oh, wait. I think I talked about this picture. That's actually a real picture. It's a beautiful picture. It's actually much bigger than that in real life, I think. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. I feel like I'm supposed to be looking for these dolls, but where am I going to find it? That's Queen Elizabeth I. Oh, hello. Puppy! Puppy! Is the dog following me? Oh, that's dope. I have a buddy! Let's see, Goofy has something to say.
Thank you for the new pants, Chauncey. Holmes, my glasses, if you would. Are you finished with them, and were they of any use?
Here they are, sir. Indeed, I needed them to prepare a rather horrid mixture which is adored by the most temperamental lodger in the palace.
If the Prime Minister will permit, I would like to thank Mr. Holmes for saving us from Lord Robillard's wrath. If Mr. Holmes would happen to remember the ingredients for the mixture?
Truly, Holmes, I owe you my thanks. I had more than enough of listening to the howls of that dap. However, I knew him as a pup. He was very gentle, nothing like the tyrant that he has become.
What provoked this change of temperament?
I haven't the least idea. Chauncey?
It seems to me that the fluctuations in my lord's mood began 3 years ago, after a visit of my lady's nephew, the young Lord Gwenders of Crudel.
Ah, yes. That angelic little redhead.
Something tells me he's not angelic.
What happened at the time?
My lady was so happy to see her nephew that she ignored my lord during the week that Lord Gwenders was here. My lord roamed alone from room to room, he who was so used to having my lady's complete attention. At the day came when...
I remember. The yappy little thing was completely out of hand. Or rather, out of paw, trying to separate Lady Leomunda from her dear nephew without success.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir. I have a question for Mr. Chauncey. Tell me, my friend, did you notice Lord Robillard engaging in any strange behavior in the past 3 days?
Other than the Prime Minister's pants, nothing more than usual, sir. But I don't notice everything.
Okay.
Thank you, gentlemen.
That doesn't help me, like, at all. Hi, puppy. Hi, puppy. Will the puppy follow me outside? No. Okay. Well, there's this, but I guess that's not important right now. Can I crouch in this game? Oh. What am I doing? I'm pressing C for crouch, but, no. Not shift. No. I feel like we would have needed that by now if that was a thing. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. This music is kind of overdoing it. Isn't this beautiful? I mean, you know, for a pixelated, you know, low-res game. Oh!
Excuse me, gentlemen. I'm aware that you are on duty, but I am on a special assignment in the service of Lady Leomunda. She entrusted me with a specific investigation, and I must question you both. Please note, in the case of a successful outcome, she has promised her gratitude to all those who have helped. She specifically mentioned that her gratitude would extend to...
At your service, sir. At your service, sir.
They make it sound super shady.
Thank you, gentlemen. I do believe that Lady Leomunda's companion, the pint-sized Lord Robillard, has access to all of the rooms and halls of the palace. Now, would you have seen him acting erratically these last few days? Say, in the past 3 days?
Yesterday, my lord piddled in my boots.
No, I was referring to events clearly out of the ordinary.
The day before yesterday, while we were on duty, my lord was rummaging about behind this suit of armour. When I bent over to see what he'd found, my bearskin fell, and my lord attacked it and near tore it to pieces.
Okay.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Can I look at it now? Yes.
This hole is dark and seems quite deep. I must find a way to see what's inside. This may prove to be useful.
I don't know how that's helpful, but... Is there something in here that can help? Oh, can I speak to her? I can.
How can I be of service, sir?
Tell me, Deirdre, you were in charge of wrapping the dollhouse that Her Majesty presented to Lady Leomunda. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
And you swore to Her Majesty that certain dolls were missing. Do you remember which they were?
Not exactly, sir. But I must say that when I recounted the dolls and noticed some were missing, I found that there were much less with ginger hair than before.
The dog took the dolls. I don't know how.
My apologies for interrupting you in the midst of your duties. Would you have witnessed Lord Robillard engaging in any strange behavior within the past 3 days?
Oh, my lord is a bit waggish and makes strange around people he isn't familiar with.
You must know him well. Has he added a new trick to his repertoire?
Why, yes. Now that I think of it, my lord usually has a right fear of chimneys because of the fire. However, yesterday morning, I found him with his paws and his snout full of ashes. The fire in the white drawing room was almost out. I cleaned him as quickly as possible, despite his protestations.
Protestations. I like that word.
Thank you, Deirdre. Goodbye.
Deirdre, you dumb. It makes me think of Nancy Drew, Albine Ashes, or Bess calls a character in the game's name is Deirdre, and there's another character named Bess. Bess calls her Dee Dee, and she's like, Deirdre. I know that second syllable's hard for you, but I learned it by age 5. Dun, 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 dun. Let me just look through your stuff real quick. Don't mind me. Oh, puppy. Puppy, it's so cute. Okay, I'm gonna turn my heat on real quick. One second. Jeez, sorry. Yikes. Okay. Tired of this song real quick. Is it this one?
A pile of ashes to the side. I can see what seems to be a miniature hand coming out. It will take hours for the fire to extinguish, and pouring water over it will fill the whole palace with smoke. I must find a tool to get the doll out of there. Best to keep my discovery a secret for the moment. If the dog got his paws back on this doll, who knows what it would do.
Okay. So, there's that one, I guess. It's so cute! I don't know what to do. Can we go back in here? We can. Probably won't.
Yes, I am listening. I'm all yours.
Oh, we just talked to her.
My lady, okay. I must press you further. Have you noticed any strange behavior from Lord Robillard these last 2 days?
Why do you ask such a question? Oh, I see. You think that my little lord picked up the scent of the robber and wanted to warn me. I was so blind. Oh, my sweet lovey-dovey.
Indeed, that is one possibility.
Well, I seem to remember Lord rummaging in the garment chest that you see over there in the corner. He isn't supposed to go near it, as it contains ceremonial garments that I never wear, and it is very dusty. In addition, only my personal maid is capable of opening it, and that's in order to air it out from time to time, but I dismissed her.
Why is it complicated to open?
I decorated it myself, but it dates from Henry VIII, you know. He of the cupbearers, the maniac for security, blah, blah, blah. If you try to open it, don't ruin it, please.
I promise, my lady.
No, please, God, no. Please,
Thank
God,
you.
No.
I must leave you, my lady.
I don't want to do another
and
puzzle.
Everything else will be open to you.
Jeez.
One must insert a star here to unlock the opening mechanism.
A star?
No, one will suffice.
Little candles! They're so cute! So cute! Where's Puppy? There's Puppy. Puppy, Puppy, Puppy. Puppy makes this whole thing worth it.
I need something. This hole is dark and seems quite deep. I must find a way to see what's inside. I think I can make out the reflection of a porcelain face. This spear could be useful, but in order to recover the doll without damage, I would have to bend the end to form a hook.
I need, like, pliers or something? Come on. Or is... Well... No, we don't need anything that's in here. There's nothing in there. Maybe she'll have something?
Sir?
Could you please clean this doll?
Certainly, sir.
Thank you.
At your service, sir.
You couldn't do it? I have a bucket.
Closed.
Well, why can't I click on it then? Do 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 do
do do
do do do do. It's a tiny sword. It's a dagger, I guess. Not what a tiny sword is. Oh, whoa. This was not the room I thought I was going into. Doctor again?
Yes, I am listening. But
I don't know what to do, 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 do. I think we should hear that song again. Song's the best.
So, Holmes?
Nope. Okay, fine. How am I supposed to bend it into a hook? Please talk to me. Please talk
so,
to me.
So, Holmes, any progress?
No. Please help me. I'm lost. I'm lost. I need something.
Yes, sir? Is Lady Leomunda satisfied?
Oh, man. What am I supposed to do? How am I supposed to bend that into a hook? Can I talk to her again? Oh, you know what? Maybe... Oh, she's gone. Maybe I could, talk to Chauncey with a spear in my hand. Ah-ha-ha-ha!
Excuse me, would there be a clamp hereabouts?
Hold on. It just so happens that my cousin, one of the royal plumbers, came here yesterday to take care
Chauncey.
Of Lady Leomunda's pipes, and he forgot one.
Lady Leomunda's pipes?
I meant to say the plumbing of the bathtub in Lady Leomunda's room, sir.
What's wrong with the bathtub?
It no longer drains, sir. Normally, the water drains in no time once the stopper is removed. In fact, with the force of the water, there are occasionally a few pink bubbles or even some hair that rise into the kitchen sink.
I don't need that knowledge, thank you.
Do you know when your cousin will return?
He said it will take 2 days in order to insert a custom-built auger to unclog the pipe, sir. My lady's maid told him that she saw Milord coming out of the empty bathtub. He would only have left one or two long hairs, if any.
Unless it was something else.
Excuse me.
Thank you, Chauncey.
My pleasure, sir.
Perfect. Come on, puppy. Puppy.
Here's what I've been looking for. Perfect. Now on to the next step. No, I can't do that. There is something here.
Okay.
There is something here.
Okay. What do I do about that? Do I talk to her about it?
Yes, I am listening. I'm all yours.
Wait a minute. He said that the pipes were connected with the sink in the kitchen area. Huh? Oh, am I supposed to do it there?
The one of Lady Leomunda's bathwater is still in this barrel.
Okay.
It is far too heavy. I cannot lift it.
Okay. Can I get help? Chauncey! Help me with this barrel.
No, I need someone stronger.
Prime Minister?
I can't ask him to lift a barrel.
Who? Oh, these guys.
Listen, can you help me shift a barrel?
At your service, sir.
It's gonna make the thing pop out of the drain. I'm smart. See, I can do this.
Elementary.
To do. Okay. Now I'm stuck because I have three of them. There's one more in here, and I need the star thing to get in, and I don't know what that is. Look at that ceiling. Imagine waking up to that every morning. Boop. Standing on her settee. Or poof, or whatever you want to call it. Okay. Can I ask?
I'll await Her Majesty's orders.
So, Holmes, any progress?
I don't know what to do now. We need to find that star thing to go on the chest, right?
Yes, sir. Is Lady Leomunda satisfied, sir?
I have no reason to go there.
Is there any other reason to go there? Can we ask Lady Leomunda about it? Come on, let me out. This is closed. Maybe I can.
Yes, I am listening. I'm all yours.
I don't know what to do. Help. Oh no. Oh no. I don't know what to do. Help me.
One must insert a star here to unlock the opening mechanism.
Insert a star?
One must insert a star here to unlock the opening mechanism.
Where am I supposed to get that? What? A star. Where am I supposed to find that? I looked everywhere. Is it in the dollhouse? Do you see anything that looks like a star? That's on the floor for some reason. I need a star.
Yes, I am listening. I'm all yours.
Try.
So, Holmes, any progress?
Not really.
I'll await Her Majesty's orders.
Yes, sir.
Can I leave?
I have no reason to go there.
No.
Is Lady Liamunda satisfied, sir?
This song is starting to drill into my brain. You know what I could do? Nah, that's not super helpful. No.
Closed. Empty. Closed.
It's King Charles. Right? That was King Charles, right? The second? First? I could be wrong. Is there anything right in the center? There is. Knock it over. Anything for me? Anything? No. Anything in the chandelier? Actually, what I could do. Turn around. All doors. Maybe we can go in here now?
It would be considered an act of treason to enter without having been invited. Undoubtedly subject to banishment to the Australian colonies, or worse.
Okay. I think I'm officially stuck. Like, I couldn't even guess what I'm supposed to do. So, I'm gonna look up the answer to this one, because yikes. Facebook. That's not what I need. No. Okay, this is going to be a minute because it's towards the end. Wait a minute. I'm already there. Oh, you know what would help? If I turn my screen brightness up. Yes! Okay. Go back to the four-poster bed and then turn around to the window wall, a painting of the king's head between the two windows. Huh? What are you telling me that I'm dumb? This guy.
This piece is actually a puzzle, and all the pieces detach easily.
I feel like I look everywhere. How can I miss it? That's really annoying.
One must insert a star here to unlock the opening mechanism.
And now we're gonna do the puzzle, right?
One must insert a star here to unlock the opening mechanism.
Oh no. What? What is this nonsense? Oh. Oh. There's probably only some pieces that you're supposed to use. Okay. Alright, well, I'll put all the pieces down and then I'll get rid of the ones that don't make sense. Alright? Is that a good idea? I don't know. Dun 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 dun! I guess I don't have to place them myself. Okay. So, we want to make a star. I feel like those don't make sense. That's not what I meant to do. No. Wait, which one's that one? No. Where? Put it back. Okay. No! Oh, that's super annoying. No! Where's that one? No. There. That's the one I meant to click. Ah! I did it! Yay! Okay, I have all the dolls now. Can I go talk to her about it now?
Why, these are my dolls!
Indeed, my lady, here they are. Two are somewhat damp, but they are all completely intact. In the future, for their own safety, put them up high or lock them up. You should also consider rehiring your servants, as they weren't to blame for the dolls.
Thank you, sir. You are a savior. How can I ever repay you?
There is a way. You can use your influence with Her Majesty to ensure an audience for myself as soon as possible. Here's my card.
Certainly, sir. I will go straight away to beg her pardon, and I propose that you return this evening. That will give me enough time to improve her mood and deign to receive you.
Many thanks, my lady.
Later.
Surely you aren't telling me that you had to rummage through a waste bin in order to find the leftovers from an infernal...
My lord, my dear Watson, within these walls you must say my lord.
I wonder if you aren't mocking me, Holmes. I find it hard to believe that Her Majesty enjoys living in an environment so queer.
What do you know of our monarch, Watson? What do we really know?
Mr. Holmes... The Prime Minister is in the White Room on your right, at the end of the hall.
Yeah.
His orders were that you should be shown in immediately.
Where are we? Okay. Are we supposed to talk to him? Is that what that is? Yeah.
Good evening, gentlemen. Well done yet again, Holmes. The reconciliation between Her Majesty and Lady Leomunda has had a wonderful effect, and we should be received momentarily.
Is Her Majesty safe?
She is in her chamber, and the palace as well as the gardens are crawling with guards. Did you notice all of the checkpoints on the way here? An army couldn't get to her.
You'll have to excuse me for a moment.
Okay, so are we going now?
It would be considered an act of treason to enter without having been invited, undoubtedly subject to banishment to the Australian colonies, or worse.
What am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to talk to Chauncey?
I'll await Her Majesty. No.
Okay. Chauncey.
Closed.
What am I supposed to do?
We're on duty, sir. We don't have the right to speak. We're on duty, sir. We don't have the right to speak.
Closed. Closed.
Am I supposed to talk to Watson or something? Okay, Watson.
So, Holmes, what are we doing?
That's why I was asking you. I don't know!
It would be considered an act of treason to enter without having been invited, undoubtedly subject to banishment to the Australian colonies, or worse.
Fine, I'm leaving. Bye-bye.
I have no reason to go there.
What am I supposed to do? Literally, what am I supposed to do? What spots on the carpet?
The rug was wet in a number of spots. I don't recall having wet it while emptying the bath.
We're on duty, sir. We don't have the right to speak.
What do you think, Holmes? Has something come up, Holmes?
Her Majesty and yourself are finally reconciled?
Ah, yes. And all thanks to you. I explained to her that you desired an audience and she has granted your request. She will receive you and the Prime Minister, but she will not tarry by calling for Chauncey to fetch you.
Okay. So you're telling me I can just go in now? Is that what you're saying? Okay.
The rug was wet in a number of spots. I don't recall having wet it while emptying the bath.
Was somebody hiding in a water barrel? Can I go
in now?
It would
be considered an act of treason to enter without having been invited.
Angry noises!
Subject to banishment to the Australian colonies, or worse. The rug was wet in a number of spots. I don't recall having wet it while emptying the bath. It would be considered an act of treason.
Does that tell you anything, Holmes?
I'm hungry.
We're on duty, sir. We don't have the right to speak.
I hate everything.
Has something come up, Holmes?
Yes. Chauncey.
Can you assist me, my good man?
Does his lordship wish to inspect another refuse bin?
Why is the carpet in the hall wet?
On account of a gift that Her Majesty received from Lady Leomunda. It was soaked, and water was dripping from it for the duration of its carriage.
What did it consist of?
What?
I haven't the least idea. The object was wrapped.
Thank you, Chauncey. Forgive me, my lady, but I just learned that you offered a gift to Her Majesty.
No, I didn't.
Yes, I wanted to present Her Majesty with a gift to thank her for the dollhouse. But what a tragedy. It mustn't work any longer. Those nitwit workers dropped it in the moat and had the dickens of a time getting it out. They were so endearing that I couldn't be angry. And it's true that it's quite heavy.
What is it? What?
If you would tell me, my lady, what is the nature of the gift that you presented to Her Majesty?
Well, it's a very rare piece, but I have to admit I don't know much about it. I enjoy frequenting the shops, and a very lovely antiquarian approached me and drew my attention to this masterpiece, as he called it. Oh, he knew what he was talking about, and his manners were so...
French?
But the masterpiece, what was it exactly, my lady?
Well, as Her Majesty's watch was broken, I wanted to give her something to tell the time. Thus, I bought her this clock which she gladly took to her chamber. You know, a French grandfather clock. Pontoise, or was it Comtoise? The antique dealer said it was made by one of the originators of the genre, the Payet brothers.
Wait, my lady, that name suggests something to me. Could it be...
No. Yeah. This was the answer to one of the questions.
No, that doesn't mean anything to me, Mr. Holmes.
No. What am I supposed to do? No. Oh. Did we come across anything? Oh, Mayette? Maybe. I got it!
Yes, that's it. How did you know?
Watson, Prime Minister, quick, sound the alarm. Lupin is in the Queen's chamber.
Oh, yes, it's the Queen.
What made me accept this infernal contraption? Tomorrow I will have it carved into kindling for the fire.
If Her Majesty will permit, I would rather avoid risking death yet again in what Her Majesty calls this infernal contraption. I was able to hold my breath long enough to avoid drowning, but that wouldn't help me against...
The hangman?
Your Majesty understands well. My fate is entirely in your hands, like so many others. My intentions are not hostile. In fact, they are quite the contrary.
They are what, then?
Many times I have found myself in a similar situation, and the words came naturally, because they flow from my spirit, which has fain been called poetic, lyric, and imaginative. Words. Nothing but words and rhetoric, often to an end above reproach. I stand before you, after having risked my life and still risking it in what I had until now only considered a game. The words won't come to me because the game is over. The words that I should say to you won't come because they are buried deep. These fragile words that are frightened of emerging, these words that come from the heart, the words that I know I owe you, Your Majesty. My queen, my love.
Believe me, madame, if I was to steal something, it would only be a kiss.
You won't be stealing anything. I will give you a kiss, willingly.
What? Huh?
Open up,
Your
Majesty!
What is this game?
Is all well, Your Grace?
Break down the door!
Your subjects are there, and so ends my gallant game, and with them, my life. But these precious seconds are the lifetime. Show them, Arsene, how a French gentleman in love behaves.
And continue to amuse yourself.
Huh?
Your Majesty, are you going to...
Hush up, you impudent plodders. Who do you think you are to speak in my presence without having been asked? Look at you, a bunch of incompetents, covered in titles and stripes. You are supposed to guarantee my safety and that of England, which amounts to the same thing. In the end, I had to defend the place myself.
But Your Majesty...
Suffice. Even the most compassionate of monarchs cannot be permitted to excuse the vermin. Chauncey, have the royal luggage prepared. We will withdraw to Windsor presently. Leomunda, you will accompany me. And you, silence this bell before I have an overwhelming urge to decapitate it.
You and I, Lupin.
Okay. That things got interesting, I guess.
Closed.
Is that where we just came? Yeah, it is. The room's not very...
Damp footprints. Lupin passed through this wall. A secret passage, no doubt. He can't have much of a lead. Now to find the opening. Elementary. This is how Lupin vanished. Here I am in the cellar of Buckingham Palace. All of these odds and ends must represent what remains of the sumptuous gifts given to the crown throughout centuries.
Hmm. Okay. It's an interesting gift for
Nothing special here. This organ is dilapidated, but the steel tubes are made of a resistant metal. None were damaged in the fall, and they haven't oxidized over time. Nothing special here. The wood of this statue is intact. It must be quite heavy, but it's possible to lift it slightly.
Yikes.
Traces of moisture looping past here. Lupin must have hooked the lock, but it closed behind him. This grill isn't in good condition. Will it yield through force? Lupin must have hooked the lock, but it closed behind him.
Okay.
This organ is dilapidated, but the steel tubes are made of...
Okay.
The wood of this statue is intact. It must be quite heavy, but it's possible to lift it slightly. The wood of this statue is intact. It must be quite heavy, but it's possible to lift it slightly.
I was gonna...
The ground here is slightly sloped.
Yeah. Oh, we're gonna put it there. Yeah. There we go. We're gonna roll it.
You and I, Lupin. It's done now. But Lupin knows that someone is after him now. Lupin, he's there.
Lupin.
Nothing special here. The opening mechanism of this grill seems to be quite sophisticated. I need something.
Puzzle. Ugh, gross.
This grill is closed, and there's no hope to force it open as it's in such good condition.
But I'm missing something. What am I missing? Oh, something on the floor.
These shanks are from the lock. Lupin must have thrown them down after closing the door again.
I should probably pay attention to stuff on the floor and the walls and the ceiling from now on. Safety where I missed stuff.
The opening mechanism of this grill seems to be quite sophisticated.
It looks like a math problem. I don't know if I need to use all of them, though. 10, 11, 12, plus 2, minus 50, 51, 52. Can we rotate these? We can. Great. We can't move this. Okay, good. That's good. So 10, 11, 12 plus something with 2 equals 52. Calculator. 52 minus 12 equals 40. What would 40 be? 40 would be XL. 10 and 50. That's two L's, though. What we could do... And that's... 102. I feel like that's even worse. Oh, wait. There's an equal sign here. Oh, so maybe that's a subtraction sign. Plus 12. Minus 52. Or it could be a plus. It could be. +52, 64. So then 100 -12 = 88. 64 is 24. So we can make 24 somewhere here. That's a 4. No, that's 6. No, it's a 4. -12 = 88. Oh, it'd have to be minus, wouldn't it? Shoot. In order to make 64. Thank you. What's 64? This is 64 up here. It's 12 plus. Excuse me. This is 12 plus 4. 16. I don't know. I'm not a math person. How you determine this. I don't know how you figure this out.
Open.
Good. I don't know how you're supposed to figure that out on your own.
All of these objects are ancient. They must be from the Norman era.
Okay.
Closed. No, I can't do that.
You can't impale yourself?
I need something. This Norman longship is very heavy and seems quite sturdy. The bow of this Norman longship is very heavy and seems quite sturdy.
Okay, do something.
Prove to be useful. This may prove to be useful. This part is in poor condition. Made a mistake. Time to think. No, I can't do that. I must have made a mistake. Time to think.
I'm confused. I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
Must have made a mistake.
What am I supposed to do? I don't understand what he's trying to do.
Closed. I need something. No, I can't do that.
Why? I don't understand what I'm supposed to do.
No, I can't do that.
I don't understand. Ugh. Again, I need to learn to look at the ceiling.
Closed.
Okay, what am I supposed to do with it then? What am I supposed to do? What do we do now?
Something elementary.
Okay, what now? What do I do now? Why is this so hard for me? I don't understand. Please tell me it's over.
I came down a level. I must find a way to get back up.
Jeez.
This collection of costumes is magnificent. All are in excellent condition.
I like it.
Nothing special here. Part of an Indian totem. It's part of an Indian totem. It's part of an Indian totem.
Do I need to put the totem back together?
This bagpipe is capable of releasing air under great pressure. That can surely be of use to me.
Okay.
This may prove to be useful.
Okay. How?
There is something here. These footprints are too blurred to gain any information. It's part of an Indian totem. It's part of an Indian totem.
You're part of an Indian totem.
It's part of an Indian totem. No, I can't do that. No, I can't do that. I must put these pieces on the ground in order to better piece this totem together.
Yeah, I got that.
I must put these pieces on the ground in order to better piece this totem together.
Did I do it wrong? Because it won't let me do this one.
No, I can't do that.
But I don't know how to put it.
I must put these pieces on the ground in order to better piece this totem together.
I don't know how to put it. I don't know how to put it back.
I must put these pieces on the ground.
How do I put it back? Jeez. Why is everything a chore in this game? Holmes has descended on floor and he has to find a way up again. In the back is the Indian section and there stand a large wooden horse. The cellar has stone pillars. On the left is a gate you cannot pass. The gate. Oh, right here.
Nothing special here.
Look to the right, against the right wall. Three mannequins, cottage dress, bagpipe. Mannequin, take bagpipe. Holmes tells you that he can make air pressure with the bagpipes, turn around and walk back to the middle of the basement, then look around the basement again at the wooden horse. Behind the second pillar on the left is a mannequin with a leopard skin. Go to the mannequin, leopard skin, mannequin carries a bag with darts, grab the dart arrows from the bag, walk to the wooden horse, there's a hatch in the ceiling for the wooden horse, check out the hatch. View the footprints in your eye cursor. Holmes cannot extract information because the footprints are too vague. Did you Indian tents in front of the tents are two parts of the Native American totem pole? Turn around and look at the front of the canoe. In front of the canoe is the bottom part of the Native American totem pole. An arrow. Bow targets on the ground at the right of the horse. Behind the target is the fourth part of the totem. Oh, so it is right. I just don't have all the pieces. Where's the canoe? Wait. What? There's four pieces to this totem, and I don't see the third piece. I don't see the next piece.
It's part of an Indian totem. Elementary. Nothing special here. Elementary. Open.
Just making sure there's anything else in here. Anything on the ceiling?
This may prove to be useful.
If you say so.
I need something. Nothing special here. This may prove to be useful. This may prove to be useful. This grill is closed, and there's no hope to force it open as it's in such good condition. I need something. I need something.
I have no idea what the logic is. I have no idea.
I came down a level. I must find a way to get back up.
Okay.
I need something.
Huh? What am I doing?
came down a level, I must find a way to get back up. With this system, I can see how the rope is attached.
What rope?
I need something. Open.
Okay. Get me out of here. Get me out of here. Can we be done now, please?
A new message. What now?
Mr. Holmes, I must hastily scribble these few words as I hear you behind me. The seconds are precious. Our game is nearing the end, and while I thought I would have to throw in the towel, I am swayed. I'm eluding you again. There is one more feat to accomplish, which to me is but child's play. This event will have a cataclysmic event, and only you can prevent it. I must give you a hint according to the rules of our games. I enter through the stone walls by first entering through the wooden walls. Tonight, I will enter a building which is like both of these places at the same time, and time will stop. Big Ben? Wow. Okay.
Her Majesty is nevertheless safe. It wasn't without difficulty, but I managed to get her to accept a triple retinue. It's strange, but something has changed in her since this incident. After her understandable anger, she seemed incredibly serene, even playful. I've never seen her like that. When I left her, she was dreamy.
Oh. Okay.
Regardless, nothing happened to her, and that's all that matters to us. I have placed an additional 12 of our best agents amongst the staff at her country residence. My goodness! Intruding into Buckingham Palace like that! That Frenchman isn't lacking in daring, and all for nothing, it would appear.
How is that? Lupin went through all that trouble without succeeding. Perhaps this will put an end to all this folly. Though.
If we are to believe the calling card that Lupin left for me in the basement at Buckingham, it would appear he accomplished his aim, although he didn't specify what that was. Furthermore, he seems determined to bring this whole enterprise to completion and commit his last theft tonight. If he succeeds, we will have lost a fifth battle, and with it, the war. National humiliation is in the offing. Our Waterloo.
Holmes, how can you be so defeatist? You haven't clearly explained how Lupin managed to escape from the Queen's bedchamber and the palace, but he seems to have had a fair bit of luck yet again. It can't last forever. In addition, we are English and must claim what is rightfully ours.
Well put, Dr. Watson. As courageous as he is, I assure you he took nothing from his quick pass through the Queen's bedchamber. Either way, there was nothing to take. The bedchamber, like Her Majesty's lavatory, are models of austerity. As for the crown jewels and other adornments, they can be found in a steel cage at the other end of London. Lupin is nothing but a braggart, a trite cat burglar who got incredibly lucky and will soon find himself shackled at the ankles and wrists in one of the dankest cells at Dartmoor. Tell me, Dr. Watson, what do these phrases mean, and where must we go in order to put an end to this masquerade?
There it is, I'm certain.
Hurrah, Doctor! Quickly, there isn't a second to lose. The whole of the police force will join us there.
I've got it. He entered by dint of a clock in a great palace of stone. He is going to a location that is a bit of both. A great clock made out of stone. Big Ben.
My word, Dr. Watson.
I've been there too.
You are correct. I will immediately summon all of London's police force in order to set a trap around Big Ben. You are both to join me in an hour. Tonight will be a big night, my fellow compatriots. A night for victory over the French who are...
Ah, Holmes, I no longer feel tired all of a sudden. The prospect of Lupin's capture has ignited me. Indeed, I have the wherewithal, too. I caught you unawares on the last riddle, didn't I, Holmes? Well, Holmes?
Quite true, Watson, quite true.
I will have Mrs. Hudson prepare us a little refreshment that will tide us through the night. It promises to be long and exciting. Meeting the Prime Minister at Big Ben. I am sure that...
You will have to give my apologies to the Prime Minister, as I won't be joining you this evening.
But Holmes, tonight we are going to catch the most notorious thief in all of Europe. We will win the final victory, the one which will win the war. We will reclaim England's honour and without fail get our hands back on the Fighting Temeraire, the Six Ravens and the Rosetta Stone. You would miss all?
These last few days have been trying, Watson. In any event, what purpose would I serve? You're the one who solved the riddle of the card, correct?
Enough, Holmes. When you aren't in the limelight, you behave like a selfish boor. A vexation, and you act like a spoiled child. In that case, I will go alone to catch Lupin, and I swear I will not record this installment of your adventures. You are pitiful.
Here, we are in place. Inspector, have you checked the plan?
Affirmative, Prime Minister. Half of Scotland Yard is in the building. The other half is spread out over the vicinity with mobile patrols. No one can pass unseen.
Perfect, gentlemen. There's nothing else to do but wait.
This will be our revenge.
The merit belongs to you, dear Doctor. You will have the honor of bringing the news of our triumph to Her Majesty.
Thank you. But we cannot forget Holmes, who...
By the by, where is he?
He preferred to remain at Baker Street. I think he is somewhat vexed that I was able to resolve the affair without him.
We wouldn't be mollycoddling Holmes.
Too bad for him. He'll learn of Lupin's capture through the papers.
Ahem. Well, Lupin is certainly making us wait.
What's going on?
It's already been 4 hours that...
Enough, Lestrade, enough. I know how to count.
Listen. Shh.
What?
I hear a noise. Like a motor. A small motor.
Well, you have a good ear, because I don't hear anything with this cursed tick-tock.
Shh. Keep quiet. There is a strange noise, I tell you.
It's true. It's behind the door. Quick, Lestrade, it's him.
It's Lupin. What can he be up to?
Watch out! I'm going to open the door. I'll see...
So, Inspector?
What are you doing? Wake up, you lot of bunglers! It was nothing, just the snores of the men on duty.
Bravo, Lestrade! You keep your men in line.
You ought to congratulate Dr. Watson. A bit more, and it would have been the longest police hideout of all time.
Calm, gentlemen. Calm. Lupin won't be long now.
What is going on? Duh? What? What? You have lost Arsene. Lupin has trumped you. You didn't make the right choice. Oh, please. Oh, man. Are you serious? Okay. Man, I thought it was right because it let me go. Okay. England's honor is flattered as never before. The press is echoing with the famous French burglar's success. The entire world is mocking the British police's failure. Inspector Lestrade has been transferred to the position of traffic warden in the Shetland Islands. Prime Minister is on permanent holiday. As for Sherlock Holmes, declaring himself to be at fault, he has decided that it was his last case, unless he takes revenge.
Her Majesty, regardless, nothing happened to her.
How is that?
If he succeeds, we will have lost a fifth battle.
Holmes!
Well, the bitch loop.
Okay. Okay, well, I guess I was wrong then. I don't know. That was creepy. What was that? It appeared over there. Okay. Well, let me look at my documents again. Well, Big Ben was automatically the first thing I thought of. I don't know. I have no idea what he's talking about. I'll enter the wall. I will enter a building which is like both of these places at the same time. Wood and walls? Wood and stone, I mean. And time will stop. That's why it made me think it was Big Ben. Jeez. It's not Baker Street. Oxford Circus. No. Piccadilly Circus. I can't even read that one. British Museum. Justice Court. I can't read the descriptions. The National Gallery. St. Paul's Cathedral, Bank of England. I'm thinking the tower, maybe. Like, maybe he'd go back to the tower. Westminster Abbey, the clock tower is what I thought. Scotland Yard, headquarters. I don't get the whole time.
Perhaps here, thing. At the Tower of London.
My dear Watson.
I should point out, Doctor.
Yeah, I know.
That Lupin has already been there.
That's true. But the message in the card, I've got it! He entered by dint of a clock in a great palace of stone.
Wait.
He is going to a location that is a bit of both.
What?
A great
no.
clock made
Don't make me do
out
this
of
again.
Stone. Big Ben!
My word, Dr. Watson, you are correct.
Ah,
quite no. true. I will. You
were... No, but no, don't make me do this again. Oh, wait, hold on.
My dear Watson was, unwittingly, very close to the truth. I believe it is, indeed, the Tower of London where Lupin will go tonight.
Am I right?
Let's go see.
Oh! It's wood and stone.
Here, we are in place. Inspector, have you checked the plan?
Affirmative, Prime Minister. Half of Scotland Yard is in the building. The other half is spread out over the vicinity with mobile patrols. No one can pass unseen.
Perfect, gentlemen. There's nothing else to do but wait.
This will be our revenge.
The merit belongs to you, dear Doctor. You will have the honor of bringing the news of our triumph to Her Majesty.
Thank you. But we cannot forget Holmes, who...
By the by, where is he?
He preferred to remain at Baker Street. I think he is somewhat vexed that I was able to resolve the affair without him.
We wouldn't be mollycoddling Holmes.
Too bad for him. He'll learn of Lupin's capture through the papers.
Sure.
If I'm mistaken, I'll be the only one to know. However, if I am correct, Lupin has very little lead on me. And will remain unaware of my presence here.
Okay. Oh!
He's alive and doesn't seem hurt. This man was certainly put to sleep by a strong sedative. There is no longer any doubt. Lupin is here, and there's no question what he has come to steal. What is his plan? I must find Chief Warder Smith and inform him as soon as possible. The name Schick is inscribed on his uniform, and to judge by his glossy moustache, he takes good care of himself. There, some cartridges are intact. This sidearm was submerged in water and is unusable.
It's raining.
Closed.
I don't know what to do here.
Lupin must have installed this rope in order to take the maximum number of objects out of the Tower of London without having to transport them. Think. If I want to catch Lupin and be assured that he hasn't been able to remove the jewels before that time, I must prevent him from using this rope without him noticing.
Okay. How do you propose I do that? Oh.
Closed.
Ugh, seriously? I don't know what to do. I'm supposed to take my break half an hour ago, but it's almost done. So I just kind of want to finish it. That's not going to help me. I don't think we can go through these doors. No. That's not what I wanted. I honestly don't know what to do. I'm supposed to find somebody, I think. Figure out where I can go, where I can't go.
Closed.
Ugh, of course it is.
How are you, Warder?
Hickman.
Are you injured?
No, but I have a headache. I feel sleepy.
Wake up. Where's Chief Warder Smith?
He left with the doctor into the storeroom.
Storeroom, okay.
I must leave. Bide your time until I return.
The storeroom, like right here or something.
closed.
What?
This warder is asleep. The name embroidered on his uniform indicates that he is Kirkpatrick. There is something here. There seems to be a little bit of green paint on the right hand. There seems to be a little bit of green paint on the right.
Okay. How does that help
This warder is asleep. The name... This warder is asleep. The name embroidered on his uniform indicates that he is Kirkpatrick.
How does this help me? I don't understand. What's this?
It's Chief Warder Smith's hat. This print on the ground suggests that someone had a heavy fall here. Someone was dragged to the door of the storeroom. The rain hasn't yet removed the prints, thus they must be quite recent. Someone was dragged to the door of the storeroom. The rain hasn't yet removed the prints, thus they must be quite recent. Closed.
Do I have anything in my inventory? I do. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. It's Queen's house.
Certainly a gift for a child.
Roller skates.
Certainly a gift for a child.
Roller skates.
Oh, jeez. Dearest cousin Sarah, I promised to write you during my first week posted to the Tower of London, so I am writing to you as promised. The week that just passed seems quick as lightning. I had to learn by heart a whole horde of coded phrases as well as the names of the important folk around the tower. I've also seen some incredible rooms, some of the buildings. I tell you what they were all for, I couldn't. So much of them I've seen. The food is swell, and the cook deserves a blue ribbon. I'm on night guard duty with some of the others, and we have a grand time on our rounds. My hours are the same as Lay, the only Scotsman in the barracks. We can hardly understand a word he says. It makes us laugh. So in the cloakroom, I've met a couple of lads. March and Ludlow, we are inseparable, and if you see one, the other will not be far away. Ludlow is as gentle as a lamb. He's always been bamboozled by the other lads, ending up on the worst shifts as doing the worst duties in the worst places. March lives to defend him as much as he can, but Ludlow always says it's not a problem, and he puts up with it. I share my room with a warder by the name of Jones, an old fellow far from being... short he is. I wonder how he passed all the tests to be here. But his hours are completely different from mine in the... I have no idea what that says. In the something, see each other. And as we rarely see each other, I've also come across the Viking in the cloakroom, a rather robust fellow with a Nordic name, whose locker is across from mine. I haven't spoken... Oh, I remember this puzzle. Whose locker's across from mine. I haven't spoken with him much, as Sergeant O'Shea doesn't like gossip. So on my next leave, perhaps he could take an air flight. Huh? I'm sending along a handful that praises the beauty of London as seen from the sky. I crave your news. Or crail your news, or I don't know. Your cousin, Robert Moore. Okay.
Two hot air balloons in solidarity. The inertia of such a ship necessitates particularly precise and stable flight conditions.
Flight 5 shillings every Saturday and Sunday, Hyde Park. Try the very original solitary balloons. Balloons tied together. Okay. So now what's going to happen is...
This uniform seems to be made for a child. This man must be of a small stature. This lamp has a funny shape. I am taking it.
You think that the game is ending,
this
and it's not.
To be useful.
Like this game should have ended forever
this
ago.
Is dusty. I must not have been occupied for quite some time.
I thought we were done. I thought we were, like, done. Not respecting the precise dosage of powder while loading the cannon can lead to catastrophic consequences. Narrowing of the shaft, explosives, etc. Okay.
Closed.
We're supposed to try to get into one of their cloakrooms or something. That's the guy we saw earlier, isn't it?
This warder is asleep. The name embroidered on his uniform indicates that he is Kirkpatrick.
I should have just taken my break, but it's kind of too late now, so I'm just gonna keep going. Ugh, how annoying. I thought it was over. Says, see that all previous locations are still accessible via the map. Only the Wakefield Tower and the Armory are no longer on the map. There's a new location, and that is the Bloody Tower. What? That's what it says. Where is it? I don't see this new location. What? Thank you.
Wait.
The storeroom is locked. Who possesses a key?
Smith and the cook. But he is out.
Who else? Speak, Warder.
Vatley Johnson. In his locker, a duplicate which he stole.
So we need to find his locker.
I must leave. Bide your time until I return.
Might be useful. The time is pressing and Lupin isn't far. I'm taking whatever might be useful. The time is pressing and Lupin isn't far. This may prove to be useful. I'm taking whatever might be useful. The time is pressing and Lupin isn't far.
Okay. Is that it? I don't have a key, do I? Oh, I do have a key. Okay. Oh, and this key goes to... It's over here. I didn't realize that I grabbed a key. Guards rotation for the month, 0 to 3, Law and Moore, 3 to 6, March and Ludlow, 6 to 9, Bell and Willoughby, 9 to noon, Stiles and Rickman, noon to 13 p.m., Johnson Jones, 3 to 6, why would it say 13 p.m. here, but then it would go back to normal there? I don't know. Johnson Jones, 3 to 6. Summerby and O'Shea, 6 to 9. Kirkpatrick and Chick, 9 to 0. Morrison and Flint. And here's the puzzle I was talking about. Okay. So, the one with green paint is... Wow, I can barely see these. Kirkpatrick. Oh my goodness.
Okay.
It must be the guard's cloakroom.
Sergeant, I'm leaving this to ask if you wouldn't want to change lockers with me. You're aware that Summerbee and I are not getting along anymore, as we tend to cross paths during the changing of the guards, and as he's only two lockers away from me, never stops provoking me, and I'm worried that he may end badly one day. You would also be next to Belle, whom you said last week we wanted to keep a closer eye on. Thank you in advance, Wardership.
This door is solid. The lock is rather ancient, and each locker has a different lock. If I want to open one in particular, the chance of finding a key within a reasonable amount of time is almost null. I will have to use force. Blow up the lock, perhaps? This door is solid.
I don't want to do that for all of them. Well.
Ahem.
Well, Lupin is certainly making us wait. It's already been 4 hours that...
I'm so hungry.
Enough, Lestrade, enough.
Like, I'm too hungry to solve this puzzle.
Shh. What?
I hear
a noise. Like a motor. A small motor.
Well, you have a good ear, because I don't hear anything with this cursed TikTok.
Shh. Keep quiet.
Yes,
there is
cursed
a strange
TikTok.
Noise, I tell you.
It's true. It's behind the door. Quick, Lestrade, it's him.
It's Lupin. What can he be up to?
Watch out! I'm going to open the door.
Watch out, radioactive man.
So, Inspector?
What are you doing? Wake up, you lot of bunglers! It was nothing, just the snores of the men on duty.
Bravo, Lestrade! You keep your men in line.
You ought to congratulate Dr. Watson.
I'm so hungry.
A bit more, and it would have been the longest police hideout of all time.
Calm, gentlemen. Calm. Lupin won't be long now.
Great. So glad that I got to see that again.
Green paint. It's typical Scottish material. There is a kilt inside this locker.
So the Scottish
There is a stool here, possibly for helping the owner of this locker to reach the high parts.
It's probably the short guy. Okay. Let me go back to... No. Okay. I'm on night guard duty with some of the others, and we have a grand time on our rounds. My hours are the same as Lay, the only Scotsman in the barracks. Is that his name, Lay? Okay, so he's the Scotsman. Oh, is it? It's Law, not Lay, it's Law. So he's this one. We can hardly understand a word he says. It makes us laugh. In the cloakroom, I've met a couple of lads, March and Ludlow, who are inseparable, and if you see one, the other will not be far away. Ludlow is as gentle as a lamb. He's always been bamboozled by the other lads, ending up in the worst shifts. We're doing the worst duties in the worst places. March tries to defend him as much as he can, but Ludlow always says it's not a problem, and he puts up with it. I share my room with a warder by the name of Jones, an old fellow. For being short, he is. I wonder how he passed. Okay, so Jones is the short one. So he's the one with the stool. But his hours are completely different from mine, and we rarely see each other. I've also come across the Viking in a cloakroom, a rather robust fellow with a Nordic name, whose locker is across from mine. And who's this guy? This guy is the one with the balloons. Does it say who he is? He's Moore. I don't know where Moore is, though. I haven't spoken with him much, as Sergeant O'Shea doesn't like gossips. On my next leave, perhaps I can talk about air flight. I'm sending along a handbill that praises the beauty of London as we've seen from the sky. Wait, your news, your cousin Robert Moore. Oh my goodness. I don't know why that's important. I don't know what that has to do with what I found. So Summerby and Schick have lockers together. You would also be closer to Belle, whom you said last week you wanted to keep a closer eye on. So Schick is currently next to Summerby and Belle. But I'd have to know where they are in order to figure that out. Two lockers away from Summerby. And they aren't on watch together. The sergeant's locker. Sergeant O'Shea's locker is the first one. That's the sergeant. Okay. So O'Shea is the first one. So we're gonna go talk to this guy again.
Which is Johnson's locker? Where is it in the locker room?
Don't know. I never pass it.
Where is your locker and those of the wardens that you know?
My locker. It's the fourth on the left, next to Bell and the new. Opposite the fellow who is on duty with me. Willoughby is closest to the entrance. At the back is Dirty Flint. Oh, his locker stinks, and nobody wanted to be next to him.
Oh. Okay.
I believe that's it. The sleeping pill has produced its effect. He's in a deep sleep, and I won't be able to get anything else from him.
Okay. So let me go back to the cloakroom here. Okay. He said... Willoughby is closest to the entrance. Wait, that doesn't make any sense because we already determined who they belong to. He's the fourth on the left, and he... Wait, who is he? Which one is the one we're talking to? Which warder is the one we're talking to? Hickman? So Hickman's is the fourth one. Okay. Ugh, I hate that I have to go all the way back down next to Bell. And the new opposite the fellow who is on duty with me. Hickman told you that the opposite locker is the locker of the man with whom he is on watch. According to the guard's roster, Hickman does his rounds with Styles. So locker 13 is Styles. I can't even read. Here we go. Okay.
This is, without a doubt, a freshly combed moustache hair.
Okay, so that's where Schick is, right here. Schick is number 6. Say anything about Schick here. Oh, Schick is the one who left that message for the sergeant. Okay. So Summerby is 2 lockers away from him. So it can't be this one, so it has to be this one. So Summerby is that one. He never stops provoking me, and I'm worried that it may end badly one day. You would also be next to Belle, whom you said last week you wanted to keep a closer eye on. Okay. I'm thinking Belle would go here then. Because Hickman also said he was next to Belle. Okay. there anything else? I don't know what the balloons are for. March and Ludlow probably have a locker together. I just wouldn't know where. It could be here and here, or it could be somewhere over here. It can't be this one. That one has to be Flint. My hours are the same as Law, the only Scotsman in the barracks. The dialogue again. Willoughby is closer to the entrance. Okay. So Willoughby is probably this one, which means Ludlow and March are probably one of these. I can't read these, so I have no idea if they...
Elementary.
I did it! I got so lucky! Okay, so which one do we want? Johnson's? Number 7?
This door is solid. The lock is rather ancient, and each locker has a different lock. If I want to open one in particular, the chance of finding a key within a reasonable amount of time is almost null. I will have to use force. Blow up the lock, perhaps?
Great, okay. What do I do?
I will have enough gunpowder to blast open one locker. I must be sure of which one.
Yep. I got it. I got the correct one. Copad.
This must be the key to the storeroom. This haggis is fresh and supple.
Ew.
Perhaps it is meant for the cook in order to prepare a special dish. Not appetizing, but I'm taking it regardless.
Okay, the storeroom.
Smith looks to be unconscious.
Smithy!
Is there a chance of waking him up? The lock of the grill has been changed, and I can no longer open it. Smith looks to be unconscious. Is there a chance of waking him up? The lock of the grill has been changed, and I can no longer open it.
How am I going to wake him?
I found it. I will make 2 hot air balloons.
I must burn the rope that Lupin strung between the jewel house and the exterior. Otherwise, he will escape that way. Quickly, time is pressing.
To get in here for some reason.
Water. Smith looks to be unconscious. Is there a chance of That's it. Hickman fell asleep quite gradually, probably under the effect of a strong narcotic. The prints on the ground in front of the storeroom made me think that Smith was knocked out and not drugged. Thus, only a bit of cold water was necessary to awaken him.
Smith, wake up. Do you hear me, Smith? It's Holmes.
My head. What's going on? What am I doing here? Mr. Holmes? Where is the doctor?
Listen, Smith, pull yourselves together and come here. Can you open this grill?
My keychain has disappeared. No, I can't open it. After you came through the other day, the cook insisted on changing the lock. It now needs a key.
Great.
Fine. In that case, I'll need your help. We'll need to find a way to get you out of there. Foremost, you must precisely recount the events of the night. And who is the doctor you speak of?
Well, early in the afternoon, the few men who were still present in the rampart were taken sick with awful stomach aches. Must have been something in yesterday's meal. I don't digest tomatoes well, so I didn't eat, and I felt fine. Our usual doctor was absent, so I had to call a doctor in the area, Dr. Cernin. He hasn't been around for long, but I've heard good things about him. In examining the first man, he appeared alarmed and insisted on treating them with injections. We checked on all of the guards and he treated them all. The last to be treated was Hickman. The doctor was vexed as he didn't have enough medication to administer a full dose, but he assured me it would be enough. Afterwards, he asked if we had seen all of the men in the garrison, which was affirmative. He asked me to accompany him to the postern, and I had hardly turned when I felt a sharp pain at the base of my head. I don't remember anything else.
His hat was already on the ground, though, if you saw.
I am beginning to see. What medication did he administer?
I really don't know. An empty vial fell into a puddle and I picked it up.
The label is damaged and the water would have washed out any remaining substance. Impossible to tell what it held.
But what are you doing here? Can you explain what's going on?
I assume that the guards who are watching the crown jewels were also attended to.
Yes, and the only key leading to that room is on my chain.
Perfect.
I must help you out of here. Is there another key to this grill?
The cook has one, but he's out. However, I think I had a spare key to the guard room made, and it wasn't on my chain. You might just find something there that will get me out of here, or capture the person responsible for all of this.
What? I have a key. Where does it go to again? To the weapon room. Can we go to the weapon room now? I don't think we can. I mean, not from here anyway. I don't remember where it was though. I think it was over here. What else did you give me? A vial. Okay. don't know why we have haggis, of all things.
I must burn the rope that Lupin strung between the jewel house and the exterior. Otherwise, he will escape that way. Quickly, time is pressing. I must burn the rope that Lupin strung between the jewel house and the exterior. Otherwise, he will escape that way. Quickly, time is pressing.
Thanks. How do I get up there? I don't know. I don't think I'm supposed to. I think I'm supposed to... I don't know. It won't let me, though. It only lets me look at it. It doesn't actually let me interact with it.
This rope is very high. Without the keychain, I cannot get up to the ramparts.
Okay.
And scaling the wall in this rain will prove too hazardous. I will have to wing something towards the rope. Something that can cut it or burn it, perhaps.
Yeah. Hot air balloon. But it won't let me right
now. I must burn the rope that Lupin strung between the jewel house and the exterior. Otherwise, he will escape that way. Quickly, time is pressing.
I'm trying to get to the weapons room. There it is. I forget why. I don't know why I'm here.
This liquid has a strong smell. Certainly a petrol derivative to lubricate or clean metal. There isn't much left, just enough to moisten a rag.
This dish is empty, but might work.
Perhaps I'd be able to find something useful in this case, but it is locked. This helmet stand is quite singular, sturdy and very light.
What? Okay. Whoa, we can go up there.
The interior diameter of this cannon is approximately 2.5 inches.
This served to store the exact quantity of powder necessary to load the cannon.
Okay.
To believe the tag on his uniform, this warder is called Summerby. Apparently, he was also taken care of by the doctor, Dr. Lupin. If I am to believe the tag on
his uniform... I got that. I need the key.
Look, this warder must have lost this key in falling. What could it be for? It's the door of the Queen's Jewel House, and it is quite solid. Was that the sound of a saw from behind the door? Lupin could be finished in his work any moment. I must make haste.
I don't know what the key is for. Can I do something with this now? I don't know.
I must burn the rope that loop. I must burn the rope that loop.
I'm gonna look at the walkthrough. Oh, the keys to the box.
This may prove to be useful. This may prove to be useful.
Screwdriver and a file. Okay.
Small dry pieces of wood. The lock of the grill has been changed, and I can no longer open it. The lock of the grill has been changed, and I can no longer open it.
Take this file, it's all that I could find. Is there any way to enter the jewel house without a key?
No, not without a cannon at least.
In that case, I'll have to find one.
You are kidding, I'm sure.
I would not trifle with such a serious matter as this.
The munitions are found in the armory at the top of the staircase heading to the White Tower, the central tower. Apart from the one on my keychain, the other key is found in one of the service buildings. And it will be far too complicated to tell you how to locate it.
Pray, release yourself as quickly as possible. Go find the key and open the door of the armory for me. I will join you there. Is that your scarf over there? Can you please pass it to me?
My daughter just finished knitting it.
She should start knitting another, because before entering the jewel house, I must block Lupin's retreat.
Okay, can I now put those items together now? Ugh, I wish I knew what I was doing. The inner Roman wall.
Now I must find some fuel for my hot air balloons. I must release my hot air balloons in precise order. I will ignite my balloons as soon as I release them. Watch out, they're off. The rope must have been somewhat damaged to no longer be able to support a heavy load. Let's see if Smith has been able to get out and find the key to the arsenal.
We're like on the cusp of being done, so I'm just gonna keep going. I'm supposed to stop, but I'm gonna keep going. We're gonna finish this. So, storeroom.
The lock of the grill has been changed, and I can open it.
We told us to meet us here.
I've been working as quickly as I could, but my old arms have been shaking like leaves with the effort.
While I'm taking care of the robber, you'll need to get to the base of Big Ben in order to find one of the officers thereabouts, because I don't think you'll find another in the whole of London.
But what are they doing there?
Well, okay, so while I take care of the robber, what am I doing? I don't know.
Enough already! Enough!
Prime Minister, I...
Where is he then, this Lupin? Does he think I have nothing better to do?
I've just done my round. You wouldn't believe, but there's a mob of journalists down there.
Well, that takes the biscuit.
It's not surprising. Half the force has been kicking their heels in front of Big Ben for the past 8 hours. It couldn't go unnoticed forever.
Journalists? A mob? Yes, but of course.
What now, Doctor?
Inspector, check the identities of the journalists. Lupin has previously disguised as a journalist, and I am sure it was he who alerted them in order to create a diversion and slip in.
Well played, Doctor. I'm on it. At last, some action.
Lupin has previously disguised himself as a journalist, did you say? When was this, then, Doctor?
Ah, well, I...
He didn't look like Piers, though. Or Piers, or whatever his name was. Okay. Hopefully this is the last puzzle. I am done with this game.
A small barrel of powder. These cannonballs are very heavy. I can only take one at a time.
Okay. Oh, and they're all different kinds, look like. It looks like.
This thick cover could support a very heavy load. Curious, one of these glasses, which resembles those in a chemist's laboratory, reads 2.8 ounces. The other gratings have been erased. This may prove to be useful.
Is that it? Am I supposed to go to... Oh. Weapon room?
This cannon is heavy, but I will be able to push it. I will need to find a way to move it to the front of the door of the Queen's Jewel House. This cannon is heavy, but...
Ugh, I already give up.
Which one is it? This one?
These cannonballs have a diameter of 2.5 inches. These cannonballs are very heavy. I can only take one at a time.
Go to the window. Oh, it's probably to get to that crate there. Yeah. Queen's house.
Certainly a gift for a child.
Roller skates.
This may prove to be useful.
Okay, so I have wheels. Okay, board on wheels, then we go to the weapons room.
Push it to the door of the jewel house. The stairs are preventing me from getting past. How can I mount them with my artillery? I need something. I need something. I need something. There, the door is dismantled. Now I must find the appropriate location where I should place it. There, the door is dismantled.
Yeah, right. There, jeez.
Elementary.
Almost there, almost there.
There, now I am in firing position, and there's nothing more to do but load this cannon.
I must decant the proper amount of powder into this receptacle and pour it into the cannon.
No! I'm done! Done with the puzzles! I'm so over this game! Okay. Where is that? Okay. How does that help me? How much powder is needed? You can read how much powder is needed for each caliber cannon, associated cannonball. Well, you have a 2.5 inch caliber cannon with matching cannonballs. What was it? 2.5? So this one? 478? Okay. Okay, so I need 478.
I must decant the proper amount of powder into this receptacle and pour it into the cannon.
Okay, so... $250. That's too much. How do I fix it again? Okay. So we'll do 250. Wait, why is this 80? So we need 478. And I forget what I'm holding. 80. To do this. Oh, it's one of those. Oh, great. Okay. Okay. Great. Okay. My goodness, this game is too long. If I had known that it was going to take this much more, I would have taken a break and I would have stopped, but I can't now. So... This is 12, right? Yeah, okay. So... I think we'll start with 250 at least. Where is my calculator? Come on. Where is it? I just used it. Okay. Okay. That's 250. That's 24. So that's 74. I don't really know what I'm doing. $342. I'm just kind of guessing. Need 478, right? I need 44. 44. Jeez, I don't know how to do this. Twelve doesn't go into 80 evenly. But if I fill this up, what do I have left over? 4. Okay. Left over 70. Okay. If I could get just 200 or 400, if I could just get. I got it. Fill it up. And then we have 4. And then we do it again. Got it.
Elementary.
Yes, I did that one myself.
There, now I am in firing position, and there's nothing more to do but load this cannon. I need something.
What? Do I have the wrong cannonball? What more can I do? Ugh! Why does this game have to be hard? Why can't I just put the cannonball in and it be done?
Elementary.
Can we be done, please?
If I were you, Lupin, I wouldn't take that path. As you can surmise by the pillars of smoke emanating from the rope originating from this window, it, let's say, suffered by my hand, and there is no chance that it'll support your weight nor the items that I imagine you to be carrying.
You impress me, Mr. Holmes. You see, I concocted this plan with such thoroughness and, I'm sure you'll agree, a fair amount of genius, such that I was saddened that none would see it as I brought it to fruition. And yet, there you were from the first. A bit too close for comfort, wasn't it? And if you are here, it's because you must have searched, and most certainly found, all of the parts of the puzzle, down to the smallest detail. And I can't but congratulate you on your performance. I am a gentleman, Mr. Holmes, and even if I didn't always show good sportsmanship during this adventure, my sense of honor obliges me to acknowledge your victory tonight. As someone who never knew defeat before meeting you, I would like to express my admiration and how honored I am that you not only played this game with me, but won also.
You should, Monsieur Lupin, understand that I share your admiration and know that if you're giving me the honor of the victory tonight, it was yours the last four times.
Your intelligence has no equal, apart from your sense of chivalry, Mr. Holmes. You know as well as I do, those were but a few minor obstructions, and whoever wins the final battle takes the war.
Despite everything, our camp suffered some losses, the gravity of which could have been fatal if they had been made public. No one, myself included, would have come out of a Pyrrhic victory unscathed.
I betrayed myself by doing anything that could have harmed your reputation. I am duty-bound to you, Mr. Holmes, and I will accept your conditions, even if they dishonor me. As long as they don't dishonor my country.
You managed, thanks to your remarkable intelligence, to deny me any margin of maneuverability to decide in advance should we find ourselves in the situation in which we are. It was a chess match, and there is nothing remaining on the table but the two kings. This is a classic stalemate, wouldn't you agree?
You will find at this address a master's painting, a great rock, and a few birds. As for what Her Majesty wished for me, I had no choice but to give it to her at that very instant. Once again, I am at a loss for words to express the pleasure that I took from this adventure with you. Even if it costs me, I promise, on my honor, that I will never publicize the account of what took place.
We shall not meet again, my friend, but know that during the past few days, your presence in our soil did as much honor to your country as ours. Safe journey, Monsieur Lupin.
What? You'll let him leave like that?
What choice did I have, Watson? Look at the whole picture. Lupin's real intent was to steal the crown jewels. The goal of all the other thefts was to provide a sort of insurance in the case of failure, and, above all, to ensure the services of a plethora of accomplices. Us.
Us? Accomplices? I admit that I was fooled once, but I didn't steal anything.
From the moment we read Lupin's first letter, we became his accomplices. In fact, by having us play his game, Lupin was conditioning us. After the first theft, he left clues leading us to the second, from the second to the third. So well that as the second to last theft, we were convinced that Lupin's final target would be Big Ben. Lupin knew that the authorities, headed by the Prime Minister himself, would align themselves with the only person who could sort out Lupin's schemes as they happened, myself. Therefore, in controlling me, he was controlling all of London's police force, and he nearly succeeded.
Then why not simply steal the jewels to begin with? Why this whole masquerade?
I've just explained it, Watson. In order to steal the crown jewels, Lupin had to accomplish certain preliminaries. In the first place, he had to be assured that the garrison would be only minimally guarded on the night of the theft. Therefore, he started using a disguise, of course, by getting rid of the garrison's usual doctor, by giving him a free trip to the continent. He also befriended the cook under another identity while the cook was out on the town. Thus, he was able to suggest a specific recipe for a specific date, the eve of the jewel theft. Then he went to nab the ravens. The effects of this theft permitted him to first create an inauspicious event that forced reduction in the size of the garrison so that the news wouldn't spread. Second, to have access to the storeroom in order to poison the tomatoes that were going to be used in the recipe that he gave to the cook. Third, to pose as Paul Sonine, that doctor who would be called in the case of emergency. Fourth, given that a theft had already taken place at the Tower of London, we would have had to have bats in the belfry to think that there would be another. Lupin also needed to get the police out of the area, which happened as I already explained.
I understand, but what of the other thefts?
A part of the process of conditioning, they caused us to put little weight on the theft in the Tower of London. If that had been the only prelude, we would have taken more time to ponder the clues and find Lupin's true intentions. Yet this time, he didn't leave it up to us. And so, like I told you, these thefts were his insurance. Lupin had beaten us four times on the battlefield of English honor, such as he had suggested to us in his letter. Our pride in not bringing our defeats public was our sin, and it made us prisoners of his game. If he had proven beaten, he could have profited from the restitution of the objects, the price of his silence regarding our failures, and the true value of our police. A discreet release was a small price to pay with regards to an affront of international scope. Do not forget that the Queen herself is implicated.
Indeed. It is, moreover, a matter of conscience for me. When I write this adventure, I do not think I...
But there's no question, Watson. You cannot write about it. You promised before God that you wouldn't.
But Holmes...
Your word is your bond. In any case, you wouldn't want to relate the ignoble theft that you committed, that of my Order of the Legion of Honor.
Holmes, you know that.
It's in the past, Watson. It's in the past. Incidentally, a young woman came by to return it a few moments ago. She wanted to deliver it to you directly. She seemed to know you well. A young woman who can be found at the Golden Lion, am I right? She doesn't seem like your usual client, unless, of course, you were the client in this case. What do you say, Watson?
Yay, I'm done. It's done, thank goodness.
Oh my goodness, that was rough.
Okay. I am sorry for putting you through that. Oh my goodness, that was rough. I remember this game being really hard, but I don't remember it being that hard. I apologize for the darkness. I'm usually done by my stream long before now, but it needed to end. It needed to be over. So, it's done now. It should have ended at Buckingham Palace, to be honest. Like, the game just really drags on after that, and it's like, I'm not in the mood for any more puzzles, and it throws some pretty hefty ones at you after that. Ugh. So, yeah. That's it. We're done with that. So tomorrow, I will be going live at, I'll be live at 2 p.m. as usual, and we'll be playing the Silver Earring, which should be interesting. And that game actually came right before this one. I'm not playing them in order. I thought I was, but I'm not. I wrote down the order that they were available on Steam, not in the order that they were released. So, oops. we'll be playing the Silver Earring next. That one's older than this game, so it might be a little wonkier than this one was. And I'm less familiar with that one. You thought that I was stumbling through this one. I'm going to be stumbling through that one, too. Because I only played it once, and it was a really long time ago. It's not super memorable. But maybe that means the puzzles won't be too hard, because I did remember that the puzzles would be hard for this one. It's not a bad game, either. It's just really hard to do when you're trying to entertain people and you're as hungry as I am. And it's an onslaught, and like it would be better if the puzzles were better explained and whatnot. If it was made a little less difficult, it might have been more enjoyable. But is that it? Okay. Good. Alright, so we're done with that. Thank goodness. Okay. So yeah, that will be the end of the stream for today. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a comment down below if you're watching the video after the fact, telling what you thought of the video. Please leave a like on the video, and if you would like more content like this, click subscribe and click the bell icon so you can be notified the next time I go live and when I upload. Like I said, I will be going live tomorrow at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time 4. The next Sherlock Holmes that I'm going to play, which will be The Silver Earring. If you'd like to support what I do, you can check out my Patreon, link in the description. And, yeah, I think that's it. So, yeah. Thank you again for watching, and I hope you have a magical day. Bye-bye.